Hi, I'm Dr. Mark Stengler from the Stengler Center for Integrative Medicine. And in my series on diabetes, today I want to talk about prescription drugs which are linked to diabetes. A lot of people are familiar with the fact that there's many medications now we can use to help people with diabetes to lower their blood sugar levels. But what about prescription drugs that are commonly used which actually increase your risk of diabetes? Let me give you an example. Blood pressure medications, the thiazide diuretics, for example, like hydrochlorothiazide or chlorothiazide. These are used to lower blood pressure, they excrete excess water out of the body, but they've been shown to elevate blood sugar levels. One of the mechanisms for this is that they deplete potassium, which interferes with your insulin production. Another group are the steroids, the corticosteroids, such as prednisone or cortisone. These medications also elevate blood sugar levels. So some people are on these medications long-term for autoimmune diseases, inflammatory conditions, and unfortunately, they increase your risk of diabetes as well. Then there's the antipsychotic drugs, such as risperidone, for example. They're used to treat conditions like schizophrenia, bipolar disease, or dementia. And these are known to increase the risk of diabetes. Lastly, the statin drugs used to treat high cholesterol, one of the most commonly prescribed drugs in America. You know, there are studies showing, especially in women, that statin drugs increase the risk of diabetes by almost 50%, which is unfortunate because through diet, through exercise, and very specific nutritional supplements, we often can balance cholesterol and lipid levels without these medications. So be aware, there's many medications which can alter your blood sugar regulation, and quite often there are natural alternatives that holistic doctors like myself can help you use instead.
For a complete list of treatments offered and conditions addressed at the Stengler Center for Integrative Medicine, please visit our website. Call or email the clinic with any questions you may have.